Hi everyone. No major news today, so let's get straight into the data.
Do me a quick favor and like and subscribe and watch the video till the end to help out the channel, and let's get started.
So fear and greed index really didn't move today. 53, it was a 53 yesterday. You can see flat movement there. A month ago we were in fear, a week ago we were in greed, so it seems like markets are definitely hesitating, continuing to move sideways here. Strength and fear. Breadth is still in neutral as it continues to step down there slightly. VIX did go quite a bit higher here today. We'll definitely look at that later on the charts. And then mixed here, still on bonds. Safe haven demand still in greed, while junk bond demand still hovering in fear. Definitely hesitant markets, and we'll take a look at those charts later. Moving over to seasonality, I just want to highlight that June is typically a sideways choppy period, and that is what we're getting. It seems like it might be coming in a little bit early. We didn't get the movement down that we typically see in May, but June sideways choppy action seems to be what we're getting right now. Moving over to the earnings calendar, you can see Autodesk here for today has not come in yet. For Wednesday, you have Salesforce, HP, Agilent. And then for Thursday, the biggest one of the week, you have Costco, still a pretty big company hanging out there. Dollar General, always interesting. Ulta Beauty, fairly interesting as well. And then all the way out on for June, you have CrowdStrike, always interesting to watch. That company's gone up a ton here recently. So looking to see what we get from Costco and then CrowdStrike next week. Moving over to the economic calendar, you can see consumer confidence came in way above expectations. That was definitely interesting. And then you got 2-year note auction, 5-year note auction. 2-year actually came in higher than the previous read, which is interesting. 5-year came in a little bit below. That's more what I was expecting. So mixed signals on yields, but consumer confidence coming in high. Definitely not going to be what we need to see on the inflation front. And then looking at tomorrow, pretty much nothing there. 7-year note, as well as the beige book on Wednesday. And then looking out to Thursday, this is the big one for the week. GDP always going to be big. Initial jobless claims more interesting here recently. And then Fed balance sheet there as well. So GDP, the big data for this week. Moving over to Max Payne for this week, you can see it's down at 521. Current stock price up around 530. Put wall here at 520. Call wall here at 535. So we're right in the range, 525 to 530. Seems like that's what we're going to see. Sideways choppy action is what we're getting, which overall means we're going to see about a 1% down move this week, in my opinion. Put call ratio still quite high there at 2.83. Total options pretty high as well at 1.7. So a little bit stronger, leaning towards that bear side, 525 to 530, maybe even down to that 521 area. Moving over to the charts, looking at the S&Ps, you can see we dipped down to that support level, 527.35. Momentum was bearish there in the midday. Momentum on the daily continues to step down. Definitely consolidation. Got chopped up a little bit in these markets. Thought we might be dipping low here. Then we held that support and rallied right into the close. So definitely sideways chop, ended up basically flat 0.07 on the day. We'll see how it plays out. Resistance right now 531.47 and then support 527.35. Moving over to the Tasty charts, really no change here. Sideways choppy action once again. Hanging out right in that second ATR band that's at 529.31. Still holding that 8 EMA 528.08. Upper ATR 533.75. I wouldn't expect to get that high again. We saw that back here on 23 May, and we have not gotten back there yet. We've tried a few times and we continue to get sold. You can see momentum on the volume weighted MACD continues to be a little bit bearish there. ATR support down at 520, so that's where I'm expecting price to go, at least in the short term. And then looking at that 4-hour chart, you can see we're definitely in bearish conditions on the short time frames. We did see some sideways choppy action in here, dip low, right back to the middle of the range, volume coming through, momentum on this chart, swinging to bullish a little bit, but really this is just sideways consolidation. We've been here for a few days at this point. So 4-hour chart showing sideways chop and slightly bearish conditions. And then similarly here on the hourly chart, you can see bearish conditions here. Flipped back to bullish on that Friday session, and now we are back to bearish. So sideways consolidation can't seem to break in either direction yet. Moving over to the NASDAQ, similar thesis. We did dip low, but then we did finish a little bit higher on a closing basis, up at 495.78. Definitely pushed up to that next trend line. And you can see the double dip low finished on the high there on the hourly chart. Went negative a couple of times on the session, which was interesting. I got chopped up in that a little bit. Typically, these are markets where I do quite well, but I just was not positioned in a way that allowed me to do so. I was a little bit disappointed with my trading strategy. I expected a little bit more bearishness here today. We ended up getting a slightly higher candle, but again, we still have not gotten back above that Thursday session. That is what I'm looking at right now as resistance, the top of that candle. is at 460.58. Momentum continues to roll to bearish. We're still overbought. And really, in my opinion, the only way that the NASDAQ has been able to stay so strong is because of NVIDIA. And without that, I think we would have gotten a day very similar to the SPY. Moving over to the NASDAQ here on the Tasty charts, you can see continuing to grind along that upper ATR. That's at 459.10. That's basically where we finished, just a little bit above that. Momentum continues to fade. Still no volume on this up move. You can see this trend is significantly stronger still on the NASDAQ. So much more bullish there. ATRs did step up here on that daily chart. That is sitting at 437.13, so still bullish there. And then as we zoom in here on the 4-hour chart, you can see it's still an uptrend, but we are in bearish conditions after that dip low that we saw on that Thursday candle. Could not get all the way to that upper ATR, which is currently trading at 464.77. So similarly to the SPY, we're in bearish conditions on that medium time frame. And then looking at that hourly chart, same thesis, bullish conditions, bearish conditions, bullish conditions, bearish conditions, sideways choppy price action, waiting to see what we get in terms of direction. Currently, momentum is slightly bearish, even with that strong push that we saw, upper ATR's resistance there at 461.50. Moving over to the Russell and the Dow, you can see the Russell was negative on the day, 0.14. Dow was down even more at 0.52, hit that next level. Pretty much the Dow was really the only one that did exactly what I thought it was going to, pushing down to that next support level. The Russell's still hanging out in here, still above the 21, still above VWAP. Momentum bearish, RSI bearish, so definitely mixed signals. Tested 206.50, broke down immediately, getting back into the middle of this consolidation here. Still looks like a high, lower high setup. Still think this is going to break down, follow through on this condition here, but it's just not doing it quite yet. We'll see how it plays out. Dow, on the other hand, doing exactly what I thought it was going to, continuing lower to that next support. See if this zone holds at 387.77. If it does not, your next support is all the way down here at 382.20, in my opinion. Moving over to stocks that moved here today, we got Deckers Outdoor Corporation. I don't really know anything about this company except from the fact that it is going sky high. 14.18% on Friday, another 4.48%. 8% here today. Massive, massive moves here. Massive breakout. It continues to go higher. Really strong move. Who knows where it's going? I assume this is all-time highs. And zooming out here, you can see it's definitely all-time highs. This stock has been going straight up for a long time since June of 22. It was down around 240 and now it's at 1,000. So massive mover there. It seems to be going higher every single day. And then looking at Moderna here, this was on one of our biggest gainers here recently. Had a really strong move, 13.68%, and then here today, down 8.5%. Looks like a little bit of mean reversion, momentum fading, RSI breaking down. Doesn't mean that this can't go higher. It probably will. It just seemed a little bit extended, and it is starting to come back down to earth a little bit. Moving over to the MAG 7, you can see massive breakout here. We've been above this trend line before. You can see the breakout in July of 21. Did go quite a bit higher, and then eventually gave all of that back. So this is an important trend line. We did get above it pretty powerfully here today. MAG 7 continuing to go higher. It's overbought. Momentum is strong still. This is the weekly chart, but I'm showing it to you because of that clear breakout above these weekly trends. And zooming into that daily chart, you can see 2.84% to the upside. This is NVIDIA driving the price higher. NVIDIA did go much higher. We'll take a look at those charts later, but understand the MAG 7 is breaking out once again. Moving over to Apple and Tesla. Apple was up 0.01, so basically flat. Momentum still fading, just like we talked about in the weekend charts. And then looking at Tesla, down 1.39%, still in this consolidation, got back below 177.70. So no clear direction, still consolidating sideways in the same zone we've been in for a long time. Overall, Apple still looks a little bit bullish after testing that resistance, holding support here at 189.96. And then Tesla, like I said, still neutral in my opinion. Moving over to Microsoft and NVIDIA, you can see Microsoft just barely positive, still at this resistance, still could be a double top at this level. And then you have NVIDIA just going straight to the moon once again, up almost 7%. My resistance is still here at 1180, so just 40 points off of that. Momentum bullish, super overbought, continues to rocket towards that trend. It made that move a lot faster than I would have expected, but NVIDIA continuing to rocket higher after its most recent catalyst. Moving over to Meta and Amazon here, you can see Meta did turn positive, just barely, 0.36. It was right at the trend line, still holding above that, slightly bullish, still have that resistance there at the 55 EMA at 484.59. And then if that level breaks, you got 489.67. Still does not look super great in this consolidation, but it could hold in there. We'll see how it plays. And then Amazon actually did go lower, as we suspected. I talked about this in a video here today. Definitely check out the longer time frames on Amazon if you're interested, but it did go lower. This has been a downtrend. Caught a little bit of a bid there. Got a swing towards bullish momentum back above the level, 181.41. If that holds, probably looking for a push back into this consolidation, 183.90 in the short term. So both of these look a little bit better here today than they did on the previous trading session. Moving over to staples and discretionary, staples was down quite a lot, 0.78, continues to fall off a cliff, still downtrending, 55 EMA as support down there at 75.45, and then discretionaries actually hung in there a little better, 0.24 to the downside, momentum still bearish, RSI still bearish, so both of these are still bearish in my opinion, but discretionaries hung in there a little better than I would have guessed, and it is at that level, 174.76, if it can hold that level, maybe that's a zone of support, whereas staples still has some more room down to that 75.40 or the 55 sitting at 75.74. Moving over to oil and gas and financials, you can see oil and gas caught a bid here today, 1.54% to the upside, hitting some resistance in there, but momentum swings to bullish, and you can see we've actually had four waves, big bearish momentum, slightly bearish, slightly less bearish, and slightly less. We're still in the zone. Seems like we might be catching a little bit of a bid. Think that's probably going to go a little bit higher, in my opinion. Waiting for some breakouts, but I do think it's going to go, especially with oil prices recovering a little bit today. We'll take a look at that later. And then looking at financials, this continues to dump off a cliff from this previous resistance. 42.22 was the resistance. Sold off quite a lot since then. Still bearish momentum, still going straight down. Support for me down at 40.77. Speaking of oil, you can see it went up a lot here today, 2.71% off of that 144 EMA, right to the 200. It's back above some of these short-term EMAs and SMAs if this breaks out. Could be quite bullish there. And then gold here catching a little bit of a bid as well, up more than 1%. Momentum needs to swing a little bit towards bullish. 21 EMA there at 220.37 gives you about $2 more of upside potential here, at least in the short term. If it breaks out, 225.09 would be your next target. It does seem like both of these have a little bit more upside going into tomorrow's session than they did coming out of the Friday session. Moving over to breadth, this is the big concern for me. We're still seeing markets hang in there a little bit, but market breadth has been cratering and it continues to do so. 20-day breaking well below that 36.60 level. Seems like this is probably headed at least to the 16s. 50-day breadth doing the same thing, 42.74, headed towards that 40 level. If that breaks, 32.22 would be in the cards. So market breadth continues to crater, super bearish momentum, super bearish RSI continuing to go straight down. But markets have really hung in there pretty well, even though the breadth is cratering. Moving over to the dollar here on the hourly and the daily, the dollar bottomed out again around 104.4, rallied up, probably going to break higher. We had 2 days in a row of bearishness on the Thursday, Friday, and now you can see we touched that 200 one more time. Looks like it's going to hold a higher low in my opinion. Then we'll see what happens from there. If the dollar breaks out, that's going to be quite bearish. But right now we're still in this downtrend, still below the trend line. Just looks like a solid base here, and we'll see if it has some follow through. Moving over to yields, you can see both of these went up quite a lot here today. 2-year yield up 0.58, basically in line with what we saw on the auctions. This continues to break higher. Yields seem like they're set to go a little bit higher tomorrow versus today. 10-year, massive break higher, got back above that 21 EMA. We haven't seen that for a while. Back to that 4.55 level. And again, we're seeing yields go higher. We're seeing the dollar catch a bounce, and markets are really not breaking down. So definitely concerning, definitely something to watch. Consolidation, sideways choppy action, despite the dollar and despite yields. Moving over to bonds, as you would suspect, both of these went much, much lower here today. JNK breaking down almost to this support line around 93.82. In terms of consolidation, we're still within this range. Next level of support would be 93.67 above that. Interesting to see JNK going lower and markets hanging in there. And then TLT absolutely cratering, 1.43%. Momentum rolling to bearish coming off of this trend line. Probably going to break this next support and then we'll see what happens. Is it going to find support in this previous consolidation or are we going to see a lower low? Let's go ahead and zoom out here. You can see right now, this is your trend. Needs to hold in that zone around 89.17. That's a big bearish candle. Those typically have some more follow through. So see how it plays out. If that breaks, I'd be looking for 85.90. Moving over to volatility, both of these popping here today, even with markets hanging in there. You can see the VIX continuing to roll towards bullish, coming off of that super low level, overthrew my lowest level at 11.77, looking to break higher, threw wick to a new relative high, looking back at that Thursday session, momentum switching to bullish, RSI looking to break out. I think the VIX is showing us that markets are set to go lower. We just haven't seen it quite yet. Moving over to my accounts, I lost a few hundred dollars, unfortunately. Tried to get a little bit too short on the NASDAQ, and then we caught that that really strong bid on the last candle of the session on the hourly chart, and I didn't change my position. So I have a 459 for 2 days from now, 461 for 6 days from now. So I'm a little bit short deltas on my Q's position. I have a 457 for tomorrow. That's already almost at max profit. It's about halfway there. So negative deltas, maybe a little too negative. We'll see how it plays going into tomorrow's session. Like I said, I just feel like markets are going to go lower, but they really haven't done it yet. And then IWM, I got chopped around a whole bunch on the IWM today. Went a lot lower, caught a bid after trying to break out to the upside. So sideways choppy action, need to treat it like a sideways market. And I just really wasn't. So lost $200, nothing crazy, but should be doing better. For tomorrow, 204 put for 36 cents, being careful there. Q's, I might have to adjust if this goes too much higher. You can see my calls are already in the money there. And then XOP, I did add a position back there at 149.50 for 63 cents. So being a little bit cautious, more than a dollar out of the money. I think oil's set to go higher over the next week, and I wanted to get a little piece of that as well. Let me know down in the comment section what you think of the charts. Are you concerned that markets continue to hang in there, but it's really the top stocks going higher? Or does that matter to you at all? And markets are probably going straight to the moon. Definitely like and subscribe if you got any value out of this video. And make sure you hit the bell so you don't miss out on any future episodes. Of course, none of this is financial advice. This is all for entertainment purposes. Good luck in your trading and have a great day.